staying still from that day, and this happened before those people passed away. Those things still did not dictate me or change my mindset or change what is in God's word for me. Because you preached something completely different. I didn't see none of that in the word, that you were a prophet or anything like that. Or that you get a special message from God when you feel like telling somebody something. That's what I want to say. The message today is titled Approval. Because the Bible says you must study to show thyself approval. Amen? Yeah. The Bible says you must study to show thyself approval. You got to be careful. Seriously. You got to be careful of what you intake in your ears. And what people say to you and what you listen to.
Yeah.
And how far you let it go.
Yeah.
Because it'll change you slowly but surely. People don't notice. Some people don't notice. Even Christians don't notice. Mm-hmm. I didn't notice in my early on time as being a Christian when I first started coming to church and moved back in the portal. I didn't know these things. I know them now because I know God's word. That's why I said study to show thyself approved. Mm-hmm. My sheep hear my voice. When you said those things to me, I didn't hear God's voice. Mm-hmm. I heard your voice. I heard nothing but more than man. Nothing but flesh. Mm-hmm. Now whatever may be going on in your life, whatever it is with you, if one of your family members died, if they got Alzheimer's or cancer or whatever the case may be, that may be going on with you, but don't try to push those things off to me. I got nothing to do with that. My family got nothing to do with that. None of them. None of them. So I rebuked them. I rebuked them. And, you know, the devil tried to bother me about it.
Yes.
The devil tried to bother me about it. But, you know, I remember the word. And I remember the sermon. And I remember all the different things. I remember, and I started thinking to myself, this is the reason I come back here. This is the reason I come back here. This is the reason I was here every Sunday before I moved far away. This is the reason I came here every Sunday. This is the reason I did read the word. This is the reason I went to Bible study with Pastor Bivens when I was younger, rather than going out to the court and playing ball on Tuesdays and Thursday nights. This is the reason right here. If the Bible says study to show thyself approval, you need a constant reminder. It ain't nothing to practice. LeBron James practiced. He's 15 years in the league.
Amen.
LeBron James practiced. Michael Jordan practiced. Tom Brady practiced. Everybody practiced, right? That's what the word is. When you constantly remind yourself and dive into this book, all these words, this ain't just words on the page no more when you get into this book. It ain't just words on the page. It become alive and it become a part of you.
Yeah.
Why does it become a part of you? Because you can discern any single situation that may be going on in your life. That's what people don't understand about this book. You can understand every situation going on and coming towards in your life. You understand when somebody's telling you something that is not of God. His sheep may hear his voice. I did not hear his voice when that day said those things. I did not hear his voice. It is written. Pastor Stephen preached that sermon. I didn't forget. It is written.
Yes.
Every time somebody says something, it is written. Those things come from the devil. You got to be careful what I say when you listen to these things. Because if you do let it linger, it is caused to change you. And I spoke on it last time in my sermon when I spoke about being in God's army. You got to change your will. Well, if I change your will, that's a big no. Allow God to guide your will. Let no one else guide your will. Because God gives you free will. He gives you free will. And if what you're taking in doesn't come from this, doesn't come from the people around you that are in the Word of God, the Word of God, period, God, music, all those things, music too, on TV, everything. You never know where it's coming from. If it's not God's will, it's going to change your will. There's so many things going on in the world right now. I ain't even going to speak on. We all know. Come on. We see everything. I think all of us in here, you know. So we see everything. We know what's going on. We can hear as well, most of us, to my understanding. It's just like this. If you say you're going to stop drinking soda and you're going to be on a water diet, somebody comes along and says, come on, man, we here, we out here, we had a Christmas party, wherever you may be, you drink the soda. You drink the soda. It's no good deal. You drink the soda. Then you go out again, that same person or somebody else comes to you. And you remember last time that the soda didn't really affect you. It was just the soda. So he said, here, get a shot glass and take a drink.
Stop.
And you do it. And you say it didn't affect me. It was just one. But then that one turns into two. You understand what I'm saying? That one turns into two. That two turns into two every single night. Those two that turn into two every single night become a full glass. That full glass becomes alcohol. That alcohol turns it back into what he was the first time, alcoholic. You let somebody change your will, all of a poor decision that you made. You got to be bold in God's word. You got to be strong. Job was strong before. Because Job didn't have family anymore.
Yeah.
Job had God. And when God put this in his book, and Job was strong, and I read these words, and it changed me and my will, because I knew how strong Job was. I was able to come up here today and be strong, and be strong with the kids that are hard, knowing that they lost a friend. I was able to come here and be strong for anybody who's not strong today. Because if you're not strong today, since Job was strong, I can read this word, I can be strong for you just as well as Job was strong. Since Job was strong, I'm coming to help. I'm preaching the word to you. Now you're strong. That's what God does. He passed it down the line to you. When you spread the word, man, spread the good news. That's what Jesus said. Vengeance be thine. Vengeance is his. I don't tamper with anything. I don't mess with it. If something's going on, I don't mess with it. I let vengeance be thine. But people like to take vengeance to their own hands. Because it's a system in the world that we live in. Everybody living in the system in this entire world. When something goes wrong, something happens, we got to take action. We got to take action. Instead of praying first, we got to take action. You know what I mean? My car wouldn't start, I got to take action. You know? Instead of praying, the first thing you do, call this person, call that person, get a truck, play with the key, blah, 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 do this, do that. And my sister couldn't get a car stalled. So I got in the car this morning, take everybody to work and come over to church. Before I cranked it, I said, Lord, make the car crank. That's what that car did. That car cranked. That's what it's going to do. That's what God can do. That's what God can do for you. But don't take matters into your own hands. Y'all don't have to take matters into your own hands because the world says so. The world thinks we gotta fit into a status quo. The world thinks I gotta come in here with a suit and a tie on and stand up here and preach a sermon.
Come on.
The world tells me you can't have dreads to go on an interview in front of a white person. That's what the world says. I'm serious. The world wants you to fit the status quo.
Yes.
That's what the world wanna do. That's why that lady wanna tell me all those things. Because she wants me to fit the status quo of what's going on in her life. But that's not our life. Our life belongs to God. We got something we got to do for God. We ain't got nothing to do for God. What are we here for right now? Huh? What are we here for? All of us got a message. All of us got something to preach. But it better come with this word. Just like Paul said, and I pray, man, that anybody who take away from this word, who will preach anything random, will be punished. Anybody who take away from the word or add to the word, be punished for it. Okay, understand that you got to be careful what you take in into your ears. It's a consideration. What you dish out and how it can change your will. Be of God. Be sure. Be bold in God. Be his sheep. Be his voice. Know his word. Study his word. Because there will come a time that these things will happen to every single person in here. And someone will try to change you. Someone will try to tell you different. I remember Pastor Bibbs told me years ago when we do a Bible study that a man said, his knee was hurting. Man tried to say, I know what that is. That's arthritis in your knee. Bad Bible look at it. Ain't no arthritis in my knee. He said, that is arthritis in your knee. I know what it is. I got arthritis. I ain't have to go to a doctor. I ain't got to even try. I know it's arthritis because your knee hurt. He said, ain't no arthritis in knee here, buddy. Look, it may be arthritis in your knee, but I ain't going to claim. It's power in the tongue. But I ain't going to claim. Don't be careful when I spread it out. Everybody instead of telling me I got arthritis in your knee, you sit here and you lay hands on me and you pray for me. How about you make it better? How about you do that? Sister, they want to bring you down with them. Rats in the barrel. You heard that term before? People want to bring you down with them. You got to be careful what you take in. What you dish out. May it be from God's word. Bless you.
Self-approval.
Yeah.
So when someone comes to you with some news, you don't have to receive it.
That's right.
You don't have to receive it.
Uh-huh.
like he said, Pastor Benny, I'm not receiving that. It's not the will of God. You know, because we live in the spirit world. We're not of the flesh anymore. We can lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Today, I got one more for you. Mighty man of God, day his birthday. He done told everybody he's 70 years old. So, I'm not going to hold you up. Come on up, brother, man of God, Archie Stevens.
Amen.
God is good. God is good. He's awesome. He's awesome. Mighty prayer. Mighty sermon. Amen. God be the glory.
Yeah.
All right, Leo.
Amen.
And he dreamed, and behold, a ladder set upon the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, the angels of God ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, thy father, and the God of Isaac, the land where thou liest to thee, will I give it unto thy seed. And thy seed shall be as the dust of the earth, and thou shalt spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south. And in thee, and in thy seed, shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Okay, the second scripture is John 4, 29 to 33. Come, see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came unto him. In the meanwhile, his disciples prayed him, saying, Master, eat. But he said unto them, I have meat to eat that ye know not of. Therefore, said the disciples, one to another, has any man brought him aught to eat? I promise I was saying one verse of precious.